We are in the world. Take care. That of the world doesn't catch you. That's what the master said. In John 16:33, he said, in this world, you will have all kinds of trials and tribulation. But take care. Take care that the trials of this world do not capture you. James chapter 4, the last sentence, he said, what is religion? To care for the people, to feed the hungry. But take care, in the name of helping others, you don't use them or abuse them. Let not the world contaminate you. Let not the world capture you. Take care of yourself. Yes, this world is, the enemy is trying to pull down people. When you see evil, when you see people hurting you, when you see things are going around you, this enemy is capable enough to keep you off. A tree, a plant is growing. Somebody cuts the plant, but the root says, no, you can grow. He has cut. So the next day, the stem is gone. So what? Next day, from the side, a small leaf comes out. Yes, but the mankind or the people, they are hurt, they are wounded, and the enemy is capable enough to capture them, and they are gone to their bed. Oh, I trusted my son, he has cheated me. Oh, my wife told me I will stand with him, and she did not stand by me. Oh, they have said this and they are doing something else wrong. I trusted wrong people. Oh, immediately depression. A group of people, the enemy leads them into depression, and a group of people, he leads them into anger, and the whole mankind is being bound in bondage. Sin is not listening, not understanding, not living in the truth. Who are you in the Lord? Many things can happen. You have not raised up early morning to praise him, to worship him, to fill yourself with the truth. Who are you? You have no time. As soon as you get up, you need newspaper. You need the world to entertain you. You need the world to know ABCD somewhere else, what is happening to them. That is the way the enemy builds up the world of God's children. If you get up early morning, Daddy, today the whole world needs you, and you have chosen me. I praise you. I surrender the whole world to you. I anoint the whole world, empower the world, bless my prime minister, anoint him with your Holy Spirit. God calls his children, but the enemy is capable, and he is conquering his people to tie them up. On the one hand, with the world, tie them up with laziness, tie them up with the disturbances, tie them up with the hurts and wounds, and they are tied up. Some are angry. Why did I do this? Why did I marry this person? Why did I do this? Why did I? All the past decisions have become your pain. People who run to him, they receive grace. That's why, do not be annoyed with evil people, not envious of wrongdoers. There are plenty. Through them, the enemy will tie you. We read in the Gospel of Mark, chapter 5, we read, who is a Christian amidst all the struggle and pain? What will happen to you? Who are you? What is your life is all about? Verse 21, chapter 5. Then Jesus crossed to the other side of the lake, and while he was still on the shore, he's not coming out. Why? The large crowd is gathered around him. He has just come to the shore, but he is not coming out of the boat. Why? Because there is an official of the synagogue. He is running to see Jesus. What happened to him? His daughter is sick. And everyone are waiting. Jesus, please come. Please touch me. Jesus, please come. I am suffering. If you are suffering, why are you suffering? Why are you crying? I am crying because I am helpless. Who told you are helpless? Yes. I look at myself. I am suffering. I am looking at my house. My children are dying. I look at my family. They are dying. You are looking in the wrong place. Let the house die. Go to him who can light your house. Don't stay where you are dying. When Jesus came to the house, when he saw people who are weeping and yelling, told them, if you want miracles, send them away. Throw them out of your house. Everyone are looking. Everyone are waiting. When will Jesus come and see me? How beautiful I am. I have put a lipstick and come. And when will Jesus see me? I am dressed well. Will Jesus come and touch me? Today I am going to meet Jesus. So I will go with a nice dress. With a good scent. At least he will come near me. Hundreds of people are decorating their homes. With a lot of candles and agarbattis and so many things. And here is a man. In the home, the child is dying. But he knew, staying with the problem, you never reach solution. If you want a solution, you have to go to the solution. If you are thirsty, you have to go to the river. You have to go where the water is there. Don't stay where you are struggling. Don't die where the world is dying. Don't tie up with that is dying. Yet Jesus, the whole crowd is waiting for him. But Jesus is waiting for somebody who is waiting for him. Who is coming to meet him. As soon as Jesus saw the man, thousands of people are there. They are all waiting. You may be thousand in number. Those who wait, they will wait only. Those who want to meet the master. Those who want to touch the master. Those who want to embrace the master. Those who want to give themselves to the master. They will go ahead. And this man wanted to meet the master. So he pushed the crowd. He could push because rest of them are standing. They are not moving. Go forward. Go forward. He went forward. Because he went forward, the Bible says, a large crowd gathered around him. Jairus, an official of the synagogue, came up and he saw Jesus. He came close from backside. He has not come. He is not waiting for Jesus to come and touch him. He says, he is my God. He is wonderful. He is Prince of Peace. He is my Savior. He has come for me and I am his. And I will go and meet him. He went forward. He saw him. Those who go forward, they see Jesus. They meet Jesus. The rest of them stand with their problems. Stand with their pain. Stand with their struggle. Stand with their wounds. Stand with their complaints. Oh, what God has done for me. Oh, why did that fellow do to me? Why I trusted this fellow? What has happened to me? Cry, man, and die with you. That is not the gospel. Maybe your name is Alphonse, or maybe Alfred, maybe Josephine. Keep your name, so what? The child of God doesn't wait for God, moves for God. Jairus, he went ahead and saw the master and he came up. Number one, he came up amidst all the crowd. He pushed up and came up. Number two, the one who came up saw Jesus. 2. Third, the one who saw Jesus threw himself at his feet. Those who are waiting, thousands of people, they are there. They might have come 1 hour ago to meet Jesus. So what? You come 1 hour, 10 hour, go to the church and you cry and cry and go back home empty. Doesn't matter. He went forward. He saw Jesus. He threw himself at his feet and begged him earnestly. He began to speak his heart. My little daughter is at the point of death. Will you come? No, you are mine. Come. Caught hold of his hands. Come and lay these hands on my daughter. Took him and going home. He came forward. He saw Jesus, touched his feet. He spoke to Jesus, took Jesus to his home. This is our life. Wherever we go, disturbances, pain, all that will be part of our life. Jesus said, take care that of the world doesn't capture you. John 14:30, the ruler of this world is coming, but that of the world, sickness, that disturbing spirit, that binding spirit, that keeping in low in spirit, the spirit of complaining, the spirit of depression, the spirit of anger of the world is not found in me. I have come to lay down my life for my God, for my people. I know of my mission very clear. I am a man moving with the vision of God. I am a man moving with the love of God. That's why I told you, my family life, these two are very important. You need to know, why are you here? Why did God bring man and woman together and made you as a family? There is a purpose. You should know as early as possible. What does God want to do through you and your family? Yes, there is a purpose. Join with the purpose of God. He has come to give life and salvation, and your mission is joining with him, and in your circumstances start to give life and salvation, and for which many things may not be available to you. You move, go to him. He is yours. The truth will set you free. And if the Son of God sets you free, you are free indeed. My dear friends, Sangamam Plus TV is God's gift for you for our times. Like, comment, share and subscribe. God will do wonders in your life. Praise the Lord.